The following UW360 story is made possible by the generous support of UW Medicine Neurosciences Institute, a leader in providing expert care for neurological conditions, discovering novel treatments, and spearheading education of future clinicians. More at uwmedicine.org/NSI.
Well, we're getting ready for my grandson's birthday party, and I was right outside on the back deck trying to surprise him with his sister's help with me, of course. Blowing up the pool. I was blowing it up like this. I felt myself getting weak. And the next thing I knew, I was down on the ground right here.
A stroke is any sort of damage to the brain, whether it be from bleeding into the brain directly or from a blood vessel being blocked by some obstruction that prevents oxygen from getting to parts of the brain. We have an incredible team of doctors, nurses, intensivists, interventionalists, neurosurgeons, and radiologists. We're all dedicated to the treatment of both hemorrhagic and ischemic stroke.
Healthcare providers emphasize the need for medical treatment at the first sign of a stroke. They use the phrase, time is brain.
If you can imagine a stroke as sort of like the brain holding its breath, it can't hold its breath for very long. So the faster a patient presents for treatment, the more likely it is that that patient will have a good outcome.
Stephen Owens didn't want his family to call 911, but his 11-year-old granddaughter, Angelina, insisted.
Because his arm was turned that way.
She showed me this morning and said, your mouth was...
Paramedics rushed him to the hospital, where he was treated for an ischemic stroke by a team from the UW Medicine Neurosciences Institute Comprehensive Stroke Center.
And the treatments for ischemic stroke is a shot of a medicine called TPA. Tissue plasminogen activator, which is a thrombolytic that dissolves blood clots. And that medicine has to be given within 4.5 hours at the latest.
And then after that, they scheduled me to go in for the surgery. And once they went in with the surgery and stuff and pulled the blood clot out.
And that's where a small catheter is weaved into the blood vessel and the blockage, and then the blockage is pulled out. The blood clot is actually pulled out of the blood vessel.
The procedure was performed in a state-of-the-art operating room called the Angio Suite.
This Angio Suite is really the cutting edge. This is the sharpest knife in our toolbox in terms of the cutting edge neurosurgical care that we can deliver for endovascular using these very precise tools in order to get to where we need to go.
That's my angel, baby. Ah.
Owens is grateful for his quick-thinking family.
If I were to wait 2 more minutes, my whole side probably would have been paralyzed and I wouldn't be able to talk.
It's an incredible feeling to watch a patient leave the hospital and know that they're going to go on to recover and forget all about us. If we do our job the best we possibly can, then the patient does not think about how they were in the hospital, sick with a stroke or another neurological disorder, and they just are able to lead their lives the way that they want and do the things that make life worth living. And so our best patients, to my mind, are the ones that forget all about us.
But Owens thinks he'll never forget the care he received from the UW Medicine Neurosciences Institute Comprehensive Stroke Center.
If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be here sitting talking to you now.